Hi, Purchase College. My name is Kay Malika. Welcome to the hole that is the basement of the hub for a special joint episode of Overreacting for one or two fans out there. Overreacting is a little talk show here at Purchase College featuring the lovely women and non-binaries around Purchase that we come together here under the hub, and we talk about 20 questions about love, sex, and everything else in between. For next year, I'm graduating, see you never, and I'm going to pass over the show to the lovely and beautiful Caitlin Byrne.
Hey!
Pronounce that right, right? We have balloons! Woo! Holy shit! Shoot! Sorry for swearing, Mom. So with that said, let's dive right in with the very first question, and then we'll see what Caitlin can bring to the table for the rest of, hopefully, her college career. So we'll start with April. April's going to answer our first question. Can you name the quintessential romantic comedy?
Ooh. It's okay, it took me a really long time.
Freaked out.
I'm glad it's, it has importance and weight.
Quintessential romantic comedy. For me?
Yes.
Okay.
Not your quintessential comedy word.
Hard. I can't tell if it would be my favorite or one that is kind of like the epitome of a romantic comedy.
Hopefully the Venn diagram will go all the way around. But start stewing on some answers for the rest of y'all.
Let me think.
Yeah. Definitely like dribbling.
Caitlin asked me this earlier and I freaked out. I just like don't know.
That's a good one.
Tell the good people of the college.
They said I would have to say my favorite one by far is 27 Dresses. Deals with marriage and not getting who you want, but ending up with someone better.
It follows script really well, that movie. Like, you can almost recite the lines seeing it for the first time. You know exactly who's who and what roles they fall into.
What happens.
It's a good movie for someone with anxiety, because you're like, oh, I know what's attacking me.
I know what's coming next.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've been told I look like Katherine Heigl.
I can see that.
A little. I can see it.
I'm sorry.
I know, thank you, I agree. But my friend Emily, every time she sees me, you are Katherine Heigl.
No.
So Sleepless in Seattle, can we get some receipts on that?
Love Tom Hanks. All right.
They're both so boring.
What do you mean?
Are you kidding? All they did was fight, and then all of a sudden you're in love. We get it.
That is romantic comedy, right?
Yes, we get it. No, they were not. It was just like any other goddamn movie. It was just made in a longer time period than the rest.
But it's still quintessential.
I guess.
It is.
If you want to go see your boyfriend or something. I don't know.
What's yours?
Mine? It's blue is the warmest color.
Sensual.
Yes,
ooh.
Actually. Nah, because I think it was ideally how like most relationships happen, in terms of like, in the end you do break up, but it was like such a like a whirlwind of like romance, and it's just like very sexual relationship usually, and it's about like two people being very into each other, and I think that's a really good depiction of how most relationships happen, rather than Sleepless in Seattle or like Harry Met Sally.
Oh,
like all those things like always start with, oh, we hated each other and then we loved each other. But usually relationships don't start out that way. At least the ones I know of.
It's realistic. I'm gonna pass over the notebook to Caitlin. At any time. Go in and out of order, pick people.
Ooh, should I close my eyes?
Yeah, I'll just chill out.
New question?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm ready to go. We're moving on. It's my show.
Okay, Mary, describe the face of someone you love.
if it's not my face.
luscious lips. Small nose.
Sound familiar?
I don't know. very cute smile. Flirty eyes. What else does she have? I'm talking about myself essentially.
Self love is very important. I like that plug. Please love yourself. Love yourself. Jump yourself. Love yourself. Love yourselves.
Honestly, we did this project where we had to basically describe our face on paper and have someone else draw us accordingly to what we describe. It turns out I was pretty accurate about what I look like, which I'm happy about, you know.
Sure.
Even though I spent a lot of time in the mirror, but well, hey, who cares?
Yes,
at least I know what I look like.
I like the almond eyes description.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
I like describing eye shapes like nuts.
Very cashew.
Yeah. I have like a macadamia. Two, actually. Okay, one. Allie.
Oh, God.
How often are you hit on? Let's get down to the real stuff.
Yes.
I don't know. I would say no, but then maybe I'm not paying attention because I'm awesome. But like 2 weeks ago, I was in driving the car, my friend who came to visit. She was like, oh my god, that dude is totally checking you out. And I was like, I'm not looking. So I never saw if he was. So I don't know.
And does that happen all the time?
But you like, don't get like...
No. I mean, like, the gross ones, but like, they don't matter.
I mean, like, even from normal human boys, don't you get the usual...
human boys. Not the gross ones.
In your life.
I guess. I don't know.
Like, they don't be like, hey, what's...
Yeah, I don't. I think
yeah,
it's
boys
like
don't talk to anyone anymore.
Yeah,
yeah,
like, I don't like.
I saw
this question. I get catcalled in like my neighborhood, but like they're gross.
It's not the same.
So I'm kind of just like, ew. Like, did you even like see my face, or did you just kind of like watch me walk by and then watch
they
me
get
walk away? Like, you know, I was wearing a shirt from the movie Tammy, and I don't think that he got that because on the back it said Tammy, and they started like calling my name, thinking my name was Tammy, and I was turning around, I was like, that is, like, not my name. So no.
Gotcha.
But alright, so bye. It was just weird.
Yeah, that's just, like, a heckle, rather than, like, a hit-on.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of nice when, like, someone at a bar, I guess, is just like, hey, like, you look interesting, and I would like to talk to you, like,
I
mean, granted, like, I can count, like,
hey,
like,
up?
If I was mutilated in war, then I can count on one hand, like, how many times that itself happened, but, like, yeah, sure, I would be a terrible boy, I wouldn't know how to talk to us, look
yeah
at us, we're fucking wonderful.
Exactly.
So intimidating. That's true.
But I actually saw that question, and I was like, the answer is not a lot, like, very, very infrequently.
Yeah.
I think so too.
Really?
Yeah.
Everyone, sometimes I'll hear like through the grapevine, oh, that boy thought you were pretty.
I get
like,
hit
can
on
you
all the time.
Maybe like tell me to my
yeah
face.
Yeah, she does.
Damn it.
Yeah,
so
not
everything's
really
through the grapevine.
Yeah. Like guys will tell their friends.
Like when I
have
like friends and they all get dates so often, I'm like, where is that in my life?
Like,
where
are people all like,
where
am I? Be like, I like you. Like, we should like date or something.
Like, we should mate.
Like,
what? We should date. Go on a
yeah
date.
You know, more usually it's like that, like, hey, that ass. And I'm like, yeah, you know, there's more. But I guess.
More
yeah
ass. More to you.
More to me other than my ass.
Damn it.
More ass.
Where this
more
came from.
You just have to look someone straight in the eyes and say, let's mate.
There you go.
That's it.
That's the other
we'll go
proud. That happens. Actually, that happens. It will happen.
No.
I don't have never met anyone who's like, no, let's not mate.
It's true. Mary, how are you hit on? Like you know you're being hit on, so like, take
like,
us through it.
I get it a lot in a weird way. It's not even like I'm being hit on, it's more like I'm being tested out by everyone around me, I guess.
Oh,
is I get the whole, like, look beautiful today, sexy lips.
Literally.
Joke. Literally.
No joke.
Like,
no
joke.
Well, she doesn't
like,
even know.
Like,
I'd be like,
exactly. And I'm just, literally, this is me.
She takes it all, she takes
all the chance. Thank you.
She's like,
you
thanks.
Give me lessons, girl.
Yeah, and then I don't even know how to take compliments anymore because I'm like,
No, you just gotta smile, like, yes, thank you, I know.
Through
but
it.
Say it in your head, I know. Like, hello, I woke up this morning dressed this way for a reason. You don't think I fucking know? Like,
right?
Obviously.
True.
True. Although I will say, and I love telling people this because it really works, I learned this from a drag queen. If any boy just compliments you, like, in any way, like, you're pretty and, like, you look nice, or, like, I find you beautiful, I say, you have good eyesight.
Ooh.
Just straight up. And it's funny, and it's, like, quick, and, like, you can use it on multiple people, and, like, oh, it's really annoying, too. Like, I was at a bar the other night, and I'm sorry, I'm being tangential, but, like, this guy really liked my friend Brooke, because Brooke is, like, classic, just hot girl. Like, she's just hot Brooke. And he's like, oh, your friend's so hot, like, Brooke's so hot. I'm like, I know, she's hot Brooke. Like, good for you, Jersey douche. Like, yeah, Brooke's great. And he's like, oh, like I'm not saying, like, you girls aren't pretty. Like, you girls are, like, really good looking. I'm like, Jesus Christ. Like, calling Brooke hot does, like, not make me not attractive.
Yeah.
He's like, yeah, no, you're pretty. And I was like, you have good eyesight. And then, like, other people started laughing, and I was just like, yeah, yeah, and it's just, like, fodder for conversation.
Yeah,
and
say that next time.
Because, like, you do really feel awkward and weird, but, like, then you're kind of funny and, accepting at the same time.
Right.
No, I just said
right?
Yes, like, no, thank you. I really literally say that every time.
Yeah,
yes,
thank you, works.
I'm very aware. Thank you.
Like,
yes.
Right?
Confidence, though.
No, it's
oh,
like, it's,
yeah,
like it's not even about confidence. It's like, obviously, most of us know we're not hideous. Like, we're not causing any
like,
no damage.
Like, whole
right?
Right? Yeah.
You know, like, that's not the issue. You know, it's not, like, it's just like, I don't need your comment to know if I look good or not. Even if I do hear your comment, that does not mean I feel like I look good today just because I heard you said it.
Right, I
so
don't feel
it's
validated
like,
just because you said it.
So it's like, it's like a weird thing to get in general. So I'm just like, yeah, I know. Thank you.
Thank
yeah.
you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, when I get compliments, I just do my Elvis impression.
That's true.
Okay. Oh, I like this question. Have you ever had an intriguing or unexpected conversation with a complete stranger? I guess anyone could just, I don't know.
Yeah, shout it out.
I did. I was working. I worked at Red Mango over the summer. That was really fun. And it was a Sunday, so we usually got like kind of good business. And my best friend and I work together. And this guy comes in, and, like, he's, like, really red in the face. Like, he's really tall, like, maybe, like, 35, 40. And he's, like, really, really buff and stuff. And he comes in, and he's, like, talking to us for a while. And, like, all of a sudden, I'm, like, realizing, like, oh, my God, like, this guy is shit-faced. Like, he's so drunk.
What time was it?
Literally, like, 4 in the afternoon.
Oh, my God.
And he's, so drunk, and he's, like, talking to us, and, like, you know, we go and, like, I literally, like, we sample him every single flavor. And we have, like, 16 flavors there or whatever. And he's talking to us, like, asking us, like, what we think he should get. And then he, like, starts talking about, like, us and, like, where we're from. He's like, what's your name? And I'm like, Allie. He's like, that's an awesome name. And then, like, he asked my best friend, what's your name? She goes, oh, Allegri. He goes, oh, my God, that's such a great name. And then he, like, opens up his wallet, takes out 2 fives. He's like, you guys just look so great. Like, I can't believe that you did this. He didn't get any yogurt. He didn't do anything. He just, like, wanted to talk to us, like, about our lives and, like, told us we had great names and gave us each $5, which is actually the only amount that we would ever make in tips every night. So it was, like, kind of awesome.
Ooh.
I made $5 off of one guy.
Right?
Won the class
for that one. So your drunken angel. He is my drunken angel, and he was really great. Oh, and then at one point, we were, like, when we asked him, we were, like, are you, like, really, really drunk? He was, like, yeah, and just lifts up his shirt, and he's like, woo! And, like, it's 4 o'clock on a Thursday at Red Mango.
Yeah.
It was great. It was great.
I love that
hilarious.
Alone.
Yeah, he literally
I
just...
I love that he lifted his shirt up.
He, like stumbled in and was like, what's
story
up?
Was wild from start to finish.
Like, didn't come in for yogurt. Just came in. Just, I don't know why. Yeah, there was no one in there.
Good.
Yeah.
I have one particular memory, and it's last year, and it was around like 12 at night. I was in South Korea. We were walking back to our dorm, and I was talking about my bra size to my friend, and then this boy was walking by at that very moment and heard what I said about my breast. Basically, and then he laughed, and then I laughed. I was like, you really walked in the wrong time. And then he started talking to us, we started talking to him, and then me and him end up going off
alone together. This is like 12 in the morning. Never met this man in my life.
Sounds like the beginning of SVU.
Right? Tell me not. All of her stories sound like that.
So I'm scared.
It always turned out really well for me, though, thankfully. Anyway, so me and him end up talking until 3 in the morning, philosophy. We are like going through all subjects, going through different buildings, and like he's waiting for his bus. He even bought me like they have a lot of these in Korea, where it's like a machine coffee, and it's kind of good, kind of not good. But he bought me one of those, and we like sat down and talking for like hours in the lounge. He showed me his art projects that he's working on. And then at the end of the night, I was like, oh shit, we should exchange information so we can see each other again. And he was like, I actually don't have a phone. I've never exchanged my information with anyone before. And then he was like, if it is meant to be, we'll see each other again. And we did.
Where? Ooh. When did you see him again?
It turns out I had to do this like presentation thing, and he was right next to me. I didn't notice until 30 minutes later. That's because in the morning, I'm not really present until 1 or 12.
Oh, yeah.
And he was like there for 30 minutes straight up. Right next to me, we're this close. Didn't know it was at all.
That's awesome. That's amazing.
And then he turned around and he was like, hey! And I was like, holy shit. What's
up? I wonder how he knows so much without having like an apparatus, like a computer.
What?
Like, if he doesn't have, like, a phone or, like, it's off the grid.
Oh, it turns out he told, because he does before, but he's from Brazil. And he's there to study abroad also in that same school. But the thing is, he doesn't live on campus. And so, like, he's literally a stranger. He's, like, not even Korean. So he's not even familiar to me as a person. And the school is huge. So, and it's, like, it could have gone bad really easily because the places we were is only two of us. There was no one at all. I'm going into life.
Safety first.
Like, for some reason, I have a really weird fearlessness, and I can't think of danger when I should, or it doesn't really come easily for me as everyone else.
Like a situation that would be dangerous for other people, it doesn't register for her?
I mean, Archie like survives, too.
Yeah.
They really don't street around with shit like that.
Huh?
That feminine intuition. Like, you would know if this dude was no good.
Yeah, and
it's also good to be trusting.
Huh? Mm-hmm.
It's also good to be, like, trusting and to be, like, afraid of.
Yeah, I guess. I wasn't really thinking. It was just that he was, like, talking about philosophy, and I read a lot of philosophy before, and we just, like, went for hours.
Nothing happened.
And that was it. And it was really fun.
And you didn't make out or anything?
No, why would we?
I don't know.
We're talking about philosophy.
Like,
it's like, it's no, it was
so
purely
making out.
It was a purely intellectual conversation.
Come on in.
There was no sexual attraction whatsoever, except for the intellectual properties of Plato's cave.
Okay.
Look at you.
That was a, I mean, does anyone think they can top that?
Fuck out of here, say something.
I'm trying to think of something.
No, dude, that's not good. Like,
yeah.
I can only think of, like, little shits on planes. And
right.
Like, oh, that's nice.
I definitely have one.
Yeah.
So this actually, as I've been thinking of, like, something to say every single, like, situation with a stranger has
right.
been last summer when I, like, took my trip by myself to France for 3 weeks.
Cool.
But out of all the experiences I had with strangers, this was probably the weirdest and most awesome. I was waiting at baggage claim when I flew into France. I was in like the south of France. I flew into Nice. And there was this guy who was standing next to me. And like it was taking forever for our bags to come, so he started talking to me. And at first I was like, a little weirded out because, like, I don't know, unlike you, I just get, I've like had bad experiences and have not had a lot of easy flow and things. So I was like a little cautious, but he was like asking me why I was there, and I was there to dance actually. And so I told him like the school that I was studying at and like stuff like that. And it turns out he was there because he was from Washington, D.C., actually, and was a representative for like talent and like child like artists at the big like international festival in Cannes, where like all the like it's a big thing. Movie stars go there. Like I've just been like seeing how all these models were like, oh my god, like I'm going to this big thing, and we were talking for a while because I had just like come from boarding school in Washington D.C. I was like, oh my god, like that's weird. Like we just basically came from the same place, and we were talking for a while, and he just like offered me tickets to come. He's like, yeah, like it wouldn't cost me any money. Like I'm coming here from my company, and like if you want, you can come with me to like this festival, just cause like you're in the arts and like you're gonna be nearby. And like unfortunately I ended up having like a performance the same exact weekend and couldn't make it, which is so frustrating. It was so frustrating because it would have been so awesome, but it was amazing. Like
that was amazing.
Such a cool
That's
opportunity
cool.
just from like talking to a stranger.
It says sisterhood of the traveling pants.
I know. It was like so scary at first too, and like shouldn't be scared. Obviously like good things come from having a little trust in people.
Yeah. It would have been nice to be a voyeur at, like, a red carpet. I feel like I'd be very overwhelmed, but I'd be
I know! I'm like, all right, there's famous people. Right
I'll
there.
Try to go on the headdress so I can just say hi.
You wouldn't do anything out there. I'll just tune it out. Right out, like, in a car.
Just, like, come under, because I know everyone's going to be up her ass anyway.
I'll just literally get
hey.
There. You know, we were even talking
hi.
About that. My professor is a cultural anthropologist, and he does a lot of, like, queer and gay studies, so
mm-hmm.
he literally went to this public sex park, like,
mm-hmm.
notorious, like, OG
oh,
grinder,
yeah.
like, pee around the bushes and see, like,
right,
you
right.
want to hook up? Like, I'm away from the wife. You want to do
Wait,
it
who's
on
who's your professor?
Chaka in the bottom.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
my professor. Love him to death. He's fabulous.
Yeah.
But he was like, you know, there's things you can confide in a stranger that you could never do anybody else. Like, you can confide your darkest kink in a stranger and not, like, the love of your life, supposedly wife or whatever. Like, and that, like,
you're trying to keep them around.
Yeah,
yes,
like,
so,
the relations
right?
you can have with a stranger are weird and creepy and, like, really
yes.
fascinating and, like,
that's
a lot
kinda,
of fodder
like,
for, like, literature and
story,
shit.
Like, what I was going to say, I've had a lot of those moments where I meet someone in my, like, darkest moment. Or like it's like
shut up.
I'm
like terrible for
right.
Place, like.
It's like I and they're often like a lot older, and maybe we wouldn't be talking on any other circumstance. Like
right, exactly.
I mean, like once I was going through a breakup, and I went to Strawberry Fields in like Central Park, and because I was supposed to be going there with my significant other that I had just broken up with,
mm-hmm.
so I'm there and I'm sitting by myself, and I notice this boy sitting by himself too. I sat next to him, and it started off like he thought I was trying to like flirt with him, and I guess I was, but I wasn't, I didn't want anything to come from it. I guess I just wanted to talk to someone, because I was like upset and whatever. So we're sitting down, and it started to become like, he started giving me advice when he realized how old I was, and I realized how old he was. I just started like, probably never gonna see you again, so I have anxiety, I have this, I have that, and he was like, listen, it's always there. Even as you get older, but you just learn how to deal with it. And I was like, oh. And I was still in high school. And then, you know, we never spoke again. But he's like, you're going to make someone very happy one day. And it was like a very sweet interaction, and nothing happened. And then,
oh, I wish someone had filmed that.
He left, and it was beautiful, and it was wonderful. Like, every other time I've met a stranger, it always turned into something great.
So
I mean, it's pretty much how you meet anyone else, your friends. They were all strangers at some point. You know?
That's true. Oh, that's true.
We're very cliquey. We like our tribe.
Right. So, I mean, magical moments happen when you least expect it.
Mm-hmm. So, here at Overreacting, we endorse
talking to strangers.
Especially ones with candy.
Older than you.
Advanced.
In foreign countries.
Yes.
Especially
yes.
in foreign countries.
Building,
that's how I found also,
plane.
Like, I got lost one time. I lost my phone. And can't find my friends, and I'm in a different city. This isn't Korea, and no one's
at this point.
English.
I'm crying,
and like
actually, just feels a twinge in America.
And it's like,
yeah,
and it's 12 a.m. at night, and like it's like I don't have any phone. I can't contact anyone. I can't read the address in Korean either.
Starts with your stories, girl.
So this is what I did. I went to those internet cafe things,
sure.
and made the guy who owns the place find me the place.
Yeah, I don't know how I did it. I just like did a lot of physical movements with my hands and body. And,
oh,
like,
that's how
I
ordered food in Berlin.
Yeah. And then finally, he food. The engineer who was like actually fixing the one of the computers was the one who was able to find me the place. It turns out it was just across the street.
Savvy traveling though.
I would go into cardiac arrest if that happened to me. Like,
I mean, come on, you already lost. Why are you gonna cry again?
Yeah, whatever.
Just like relax, let it
flow.
Yeah, it happens to me all the time. That's the problem. It's like
we have to buy
I'm
you a
always
mask.
Like losing shit or losing something very important, and no one knows where I am, and I have to like figure out my shit.
Yeah, good girl.
Happens.
We give a lot too. I Irish exit way too often, and I'm just wandering around, and people are like, where are you? And I don't know.
Around.
And they don't know. And no one knows. Until tomorrow.
Sounds
until
deep.
Until I show up again.
Yeah. I actually have one, too. I went to LaGuardia High School in the city, and one day...
Fiorello?
Fiorello H. Yeah.
I'm gonna live forever.
That's the thing in high school, if anyone doesn't know.
I'm gonna pick this one up.
Great movie, there are boobies in it. Seek it out.
One day, I cut class. And I was sitting in Le Pain Quotidien, and I was doing, you know, work or whatever, and this woman came up to me, and she was really old. She was like in her 80s. And she just started talking to me, and her name was Audrey Rose, and she was asking me about what I was doing at LaGuardia, and she was asking me about like how I'm gonna pursue theater, and we got into this super long conversation. She bought me tea, and then she said, I live in the apartment building right across the street from LaGuardia. Here's my number. If you ever want tea again, just text me. She texts, she's like 80,
oh my God.
She texted. She's so cute.
That's awesome.
Actually, that's the best story I've ever heard. Anyone who offers me tea is a lifelong friend.
That's very good.
That's awesome.
Adorable.
Tea now.
I'm not trying to say.
Do you want some tea?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a drying agent.
What is the coolest thing you've ever done? No pressure.
Right?
Coolest thing I've ever done. I'm just generally cool, so
I'm a cool person, so anything I do.
Hey, that's the answer. Cool's a lifestyle. I wouldn't know.
I used to have a shirt with monkeys on it that said totally cool, and the monkeys were all wearing sunglasses, so
that's
kind of my coolest thing.
Best thing I've ever done is buy that shirt.
Right?
The coolest thing is how I get to ride in a limo.
When do you often ride in a limo?
No.
But like your ride? Like
no. It's crazy actually, the story. It's like one of those should have been dangerous but didn't.
I have a feeling this happened so long.
So it's fucking summer and my parents are very strict, so I can never tell them where I'm going. So when I usually leave, I have to sleep at one of my friends' house and have that set. But the friend whose house I was planning to sleep with is going to sleep with her boyfriend, so here's a dilemma. So I decided to go off with one of my friends who's going back into the city to see one of their boyfriends at like the standard hotel. And I was like, okay, I'll go. So she goes in. Before we go in, it's like 1 in the morning, and she goes for a drink, actually, at one of the bars. So you know it's already a bad situation. We're underage at this time.
Gotcha.
So she goes into a bar, takes someone a drink. She has a fake ID, I don't even drink. But we leave the bar, and then we go to a standard hotel, which is on the west side, and there's like limos parked outside for any drunk, rich people who want to take a limo rather than a normal cab. And my phone is dead. So she goes in, I'm waiting outside for her, because I can't get into the club because I don't have a fake ID or anything like this, because I wasn't planning not to go out that night in that way anyway. So I'm outside. I know that she's gonna take a while because she already took a drink, you know. So her sense of time is probably a bit
warped.
So she goes in, it's like 10 minutes past, and I'm holding shopping bags. We have been shopping the whole day, we have been out the whole day. And then for some
reason. I was like, damn, how the fuck am I going to charge my phone? I need to get somewhere. So I make this limo driver charge my phone in his car. I was like, do you have a USB? And then I started talking about myself to him, which I do naturally to everyone. And then he's talking to me, keep calling me a dangerous girl and stuff. He leaves his job in the end and drives me to the train station, which is on the east side. But before then, he asked me if I wanted to go to a quiet area in the neighborhood and talk. I was like, sure, why not?
Safe. Yes, keep going.
No, I'm fascinated. Mommy and Daddy are just...
Oh, okay. So, what did I do? Oh, we end up in this quiet area. It's just like around the same area anyway. So I get into the limo with him, and he like goes into this like section, and that was quiet, I guess. But I told him to keep the windows open and the door open if I need to, in case I needed to jump out. I actually said this out loud to him. And yes,
it was an open.
Oh my god!
They were open about this.
he laughed. He thought I was hilarious. He did keep the windows open and the door open. He still charged my phone. And then I texted one of my friends. I was like, "Oh shit, I'm in a limo with this guy. I don't know." And then he's like, "They're all freaking out. Like she because it's like 2 a.m. She's everyone is asleep." Except for one friend who ended up driving me to this train station where I get on the train and then go to our house to sleep over for the night, because there's no way in hell I'm gonna go home because my parents will actually murder me.
You slept at a limo driver's house?
No, the limo driver's house. I was at my friend's house, but the limo driver would just basically drive me to the train station, which was really nice. And he did try something. He tried to put his arm around me. I was like, no.
Oh, God.
I was
like, expecting it.
One of those situations
that I would cry in again.
No, I just, like, told him literally no, and he respect that completely. I think with most people, and then we exchanged numbers, and then Christmas, he texted me. He was like, Merry Christmas, Alex Limo. That's how I knew it was him.
Alex Limo. She's Louise. Okay, I hate to disrupt this flow, but we have 10 minutes, so maybe we can do, like, speed round.
Okay.
Yes, do what you will, new host. I'm graduating, bye.
I'll ask question and point, and you answer question.
Yes, come on, authority.
Does happiness come easy to you?
Yes.
When?
Dancing, laughing, being with friends, eating food, playing
yes.
with dogs.
Slam
yeah.
poetry.
Yelling, screaming,
moving
my
head
in the air. In bed.
I am talking
bed.
To you.
Oh my god, everybody
sleeping.
My bed.
In my bed at home, though.
Nope. I tell Andy, my roommate, every night I lay in bed. I'm
Shut
sure
up.
She's so sick of it. Lay in bed, but this is the favorite part of every day. My favorite part of every day.
Is laying in bed.
Laying in my bed.
I'm glad
you look confused too.
Name a green thing that you love.
Not that balloon.
It's yellow. Also.
A green thing I love.
The green.
Kale.
Plants.
Woo! I like plants too.
Plants rocks.
Actually, I was asking myself this question before. What is something that you knew? What is something you wish you knew more about? And I said plants before.
Oh.
Okay. I don't know why I said plants. What do you wish you were more educated about?
This is a good one. Tactile skill of an instrument. It would be really classy if I could play piano, like, just really well. Just wail on that thing whenever I want to learn any piano.
Agreed.
That'd be
yeah.
true.
You could really take any emotion out on an instrument. That's what I would want it for.
So
just
so
if I'm mad, just to, like, play mad.
Yeah.
Or, like, happy. Play happy. You know?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you hope to learn this summer? Graduating senior, stepping out into the world.
Oh, no.
Huh.
Oh, she's whispering to me, something inappropriate, probably.
She's with class, Mary.
How to make friends outside of school. Because, you know, we're all in this We're all the same age. We live in a small town of friends that, you know, I mean, we all go to the same classes. She's listening to me clearly. but yeah, I think I want to know how to make friends that last after school.
Yeah, like no icebreakers in the real world. Like,
right.
Yeah.
Like no icebreaker games.
Yeah, no.
Like I'm not going to know anyone's favorite ice cream or anything.
It's truly my goal of the summer.
Just this into someone's eye deeply enough. Those is something.
And then you get arrested.
Ask questions like these.
Right?
Go around with your own icebreaker.
No, you don't get arrested.
I have this book of cards called like Flirting Made Easy, and it's like you check a box like I think you're cute or funny or like handsome or chic, and you just check a box and hand it to whoever, like hand it to someone that you see.
You're
and
zesty.
You don't have to,
you're zesty.
You don't have to worry about the words. You can just like let the cards play their role.
That's
let
cool.
The, that's cool, right? That's a cool thing to do.
That's cute.
Thank you.
I want to think of a really good closing question because we don't have that much time left.
Oh.
It's
gonna
be juicy.
Taste your thought.
Let's breathe.
Case of pure reading. What do you wish for at your parents' age?
Not to be my parents.
Ooh.
Kids is
cool.
But
I love you, Mom. And Dad. And sister. Sort of Mom.
I mean, I think ideally I want my parents to be in Africa at this moment. Sincerely, or Guinea actually, specifically, with their own house. And what else will I want? 6 months of work, 6 months of vacation.
Pretty much. Wow.
So. But you have to understand, my parents are like 40 and 60.
Wait, what was the question? What do you want?
What do you wish for at your parents' age?
Like
when you're at your parents' age?
Okay.
Like I said before, I want to have kids as cool as me and my siblings.
Yeah, I want to have kids
that's
by
pretty,
then.
That's pretty,
yeah.
That's,
I definitely want to have kids by then.
If I'm like, acting out and like throwing toot at my mom, she's like, I hope you have kids just like yourself.
And
one day.
All of a sudden,
I hope so
check.
Too. Like,
really?
I hope my kids are exactly
like me. I'm just like, all right, I'm gonna be a sweet angel now. If they ever said that to me, I'd be like, never mind.
Imagine having a child like me.
I would beat them every day.
I think I just want stability and to have like found love by then, or at least
yes.
Like a love. Jesus Christ, call me.
Oh my God, my parents are so old.
I'm not bitter.
I hope my body doesn't hurt.
That's a good one.
Very true.
It probably
yeah.
Will.
I hope I'm as healthy as my mom. She has great skin. She looks 20 years
yeah,
younger than she actually is.
Awesome looking.
And I wish I could tell you how old she is, but she doesn't tell me anymore.
I know, I just think my parents
she
are 100.
Really she's been the same age for, like, the past 5 years.
Oh, my God, my dad is in really, 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 really good shape. Like, it's actually a little scary.
Do you want that?
How old is he?
He's 62.
My dad
wow.
is, too, and he's in really good shape, and that's because my dad grooms like no other person.
My dad does kung fu, and he's a professional
what?
Dancer, so.
Oh,
yeah, so
he
amazing.
Does none of that. I think he diets my dad. No.
My grandma does yoga on a chair.
What?
So
I
want to
be
cute.
That kind of grandma.
Adorable, right?
Adorable, badass.
Yeah. Both.
Yoga on a chair.
Chair yoga.
Chair
let's
yoga.
Do some.
I'm in jeans.
Yeah.
It's just not happening.
Close out with chair yoga.
Chair yoga. All
right. Everyone cross your legs.
I have a skirt on, so like I'm going to reach
just
third eye.
And let's share a gentle ohm.
Oh, damn. Your yoga all
Mabi.
Over my hands.
Mabi.
Oh.
Oh. This guy.
Close up. So, I'm Caitlin.
That's Caitlin.
I'm
hosting maybe soon, one day, definitely. This is Kay and I's first and last show together, so thank you for having me on, and thank you for letting me take your place. And this was a really, really fun thing, and I'm excited to keep on doing it.
We're going
to
do more. You're going to do more. I'm irrelevant. Don't look at me.
Stop it at all.
It's true. Are we all really here? Just a figment.
What is here?
It's just a dream. Bye.
Bye.